everyone, and welcome to my studio. I'm Linda Peterson, and thanks for joining me in the studio today for Spellbinders Mixed Media Monday. We are celebrating spring, and I'm going to show you how to create a birdhouse topiary with some recycled materials. For the main portion of the birdhouse, I'm going to be using the number 7 die, with the number 1 being the smallest, from the 5x7 Matting Basics die template set. And you can see that I have it positioned on my cardboard, which is on my cutting plate. Complete the sandwich with the base plate, and I'm going to be passing this through my Grand Calibur machine to cut it out. In addition to the rectangle that you've just cut out, you'll want to cut out 2 circles from the standard circles die template set, the number 7 and the number 5. If you want to cut a little door in your birdhouse, you don't have to, it's an option, but I have cut a hole in the center of my rectangle, as you can see here, or my half a rectangle, using the number 1, or the smallest, of the circles 3 die template set from the Media Mixáge line. And I've just kind of eyed the center. To give my birdhouse a little bit of texture and a little bit of interest, I'm going to peel away some of the cardboard. I have a little bit of white paint on the edge of my cosmetic sponge here, and I'm just going to shabby up a little bit by just highlighting the top of the cardboard with the white paint. You'll do the exact same thing on the circles. It's time to assemble the birdhouse, and the easiest way that I have found and the quickest is just to use some hot glue. So right along the edge here with some hot glue and fold it around. The smaller circle is your base, so apply a little hot glue to the bottom of your birdhouse. Center it right over the base. Set this aside for just a minute. We're going to make the dome on the top of the roof. So what you'll do with a pair of scissors is just cut halfway up and create a cone. By folding it over, you can see that cone dome effect. And then glue it to the top of your birdhouse. You want to make sure that your seams are both in the back, both the seam from the roof and the seam from the birdhouse itself. I finished the topiary by inserting a skewer into the bottom with the opposite end pressed into the foam that's inside the pot. I've also added little flower accents from the cherry blossom set and embellished the top using a brass butterfly blank from the Media Mixáge line. It is so much fun working with the Spellbinders line of dies, and you can see the entire line on our website at spellbinderscreativearts.com. Please make sure to click the like button, leave us a comment, let us know what you think of this video, and please give a suggestion for what you'd like to see in upcoming videos. And that's going to wrap it up for me today in the studio, but I'll be back again to share more tips, techniques, and ideas with you. Until then, remember, the possibilities are endless when you explore beyond.